actually just beneficial. They don't sting unless they're in threatened, you know, if they get stepped on or something. And even then, sometimes they don't hurt you. And we have children, so that's also a concern. And it's really just a cool experience to be able to bring more nature back to the suburb city that we live in. When we first moved into our house, there was just like three trees, and all the rest was grass with moss and weeds and just basically muck. Anytime it rained, it would turn into a muck soup. And it's just really exciting because, you know, what we've done, we've dug up most of the grass and put in lots of gardens and lots of perennial flowers and herbs and fruit trees and bushes, and all on a third of an acre. And it's really amazing what you can do when you just do it little by little and step by step, and just, you know, don't overwhelm yourself, just plan. And now I think we're at like year 5 at this house, and we're finally doing the mason bees. It's pretty exciting. And, you know, one thing that I've noticed is a lot of people saying, you know, we need to protect the bees, we need to figure out what's happening to all the bees. And I know that there's a lot of pesticide chemicals being sprayed, and that's part of why the bees are disappearing. But if you also look at it, for a while the gardeners have been disappearing. The land utilization for grass instead of, you know, fruiting and flowering plants decreases the environment space for the bees and other insects and pollinators as well. So it's really important to stay organic in your garden and to, you know, introduce more things like mason bees and ladybugs and perennial flowers and other kinds of beneficial companion plants to your garden, so you can grow organically, which is definitely one of the most beneficial things if you're going to ingest any of your plants, is to have organic plants that are non-genetically modified, because our bodies aren't able to recognize genetically modified foods and pesticide foods as food. They're actually recognizing it as a foreign body that it needs to attack. And that's what I found out is a lot of the reasons why my children were going through sensitivities with food and chemicals, and chemical cleaners and the chemicals in the air and things like that, is because they're rejecting it. Basically, they're saying, no, this is not what my parents ate, this is not what my grandparents' grandparents, and so on. It's not what they ingested. It's a foreign matter. It's in our DNA, you know. We have that ability to recognize things and as, you know, foreign or non-foreign, and it's important to have organic food that our body recognizes. Besides, even if you're not eating the food and you just have a flower garden, if you look at it like this, most pesticides are made up of the same exact thing that Agent Orange was made up of. If you know what Agent Orange is, it's an extremely toxic chemical that was sprayed and used as chemical warfare in Vietnam War, I believe, and it's probably used elsewhere as well. But now I've heard that that's actually the main ingredients of Roundup. And so a lot of people are spraying this stuff all over their house and hurting their own health, hurting their pets, hurting their children. And so once you know that this is a toxin and it's not beneficial for our bodies, and then it's basically poisoning if you're allowing this to be sprayed on your property or be sprayed around your children. It's just really important to look at the value of companion plants and insects that are beneficial, that can make a sustainable garden and a sustainable supply of food and nutrition. That is really what I want to say about the bees. I'm just really excited about bringing bees to our house and having more pollinators for our garden. It's a wonderful prospect. Blessings, and have a good day.